Ed Orgeron. Everyone, like my kid, my 8-year-old, said watching the national championship game, I love him when he showed up on the screen. I love him, Dad.
Yeah, my daughter, you know? my daughter thought he was great. My wife watched him when he came on screen and said, that's not real. She just went, no way. She goes, is that somebody doing a character?
It's
I'm
real.
Like, no, that's Cookie Monster. And every time I try to do it, I was like, he does that. He has that press. I'm trying to have a press conference. Trying to have a press conference. And it's always says, like, C is for Cookie. It's good enough for me. Like, you're just waiting for somebody to dump truck a bunch of cookies in there, and he's going to teach it.
Today we're going to learn about the letter C.
It's like, what the heck is going on? Hey, could you break that up a little louder over there? Holy cow, Eisen!
I know.
I told you we needed this place soundproofed. I do prop comedy and audiovisual material.
By the way, that was very sound. That sounded like Schefter a little bit.
That's Schefter?
When you go hire a register
according
for Schefter.
According to my sources, I was told, that's Adam Schefter yelling, I was told that there would be absolutely no heavy-duty truck movement during this.
Jay Glazer comes in. Listen, I don't know what you heard. I didn't say it. It's had nothing to do with me. But there are a lot of people saying, there are a lot of people talking about these trucks. I don't know. Did you hear about the Demi Lovato thing? Did you hear about that? Did you punch my tooth out? Listen, I was working out. A lot of people. I'm an NFL insider. If you don't know who that is, look it up. Google it right now on your phone. There's a lot more humorous segment. So let me just say this. So watch pregame. Watch pregame. It's going to be an incredible pregame. I'm going to lift weights.
I sat next to him on the flight out here 5 hours.
Did
next,
you really?
Next to Glaze.
How much about him did you hear about?
Oh.
No, he's the best.
He's the great.
He got me kicked out of the first Super Bowl I ever went to.
What?
Yeah.
Come on.
So it was in Jacksonville. Was it Fox at the time?
Yeah, Eagles, Patriots.
He goes, oh, you got to see this. This is going to be amazing. You got to come down to the sideline and watch the planes go over the national anthem. It's the most amazing thing you've ever seen in your entire life.
I'm like, okay. I gotta.
You have a child yet? No. It's going to be better than that. It's going to be incredible.
So I go down there, the national anthem, the planes fly over. It's like, what was that like? I'm like, it was incredible. Somebody comes over from the NFL. They're like, where's your credential? I hold up my credential, which has a green marking on it.
Yeah.
Which the people at Fox told me, you can go on the field if you want. You can kick the ball if you feel like it. I didn't make that attempt at any point. So they're like, you can kick the ball. I'm like, I'll hold off on that. They goes, no, what are you doing down here? I go, really, I'm just here to watch this because my friend Jay, which I use the term friend lightly now.
Yeah.
But I was like, my friend Jay said, come down here and watch this. He's like, okay, you got to go. I was like, okay. And I questioned. Not like a jerk. I just questioned like, hey, but doesn't this pass mean? He goes, just go. I go, doesn't this pass mean? He goes, that's it. Rips the credential off me, kicked me out of the Super Bowl. And I was kicked out of Jacksonville, the entire stadium, just out on the street, crying. Just crying. Just sitting there like, what am I supposed to do? I'm not at the Super. And before I had done the impression of all the guys on the pregame show, Fox had it. So I was like, what do I do? I finally sneaked my way back in because the security guards were hitting on some girl. So I waited for that. They're like, hey, you know, we're guarding the stadium. Meanwhile, I'm sneaking through tippy toes, kind of like Shaggy. He's always like, hey, Scoob, like, let's make a break for it. And then we ran. Our feet traveled in circles for a little bit before we went. And there was no dog with me, but I thought there was. So I get in there. They're laughing at the good parts now. So I get in there, and I say to the president of Fox Sports, David Hill, I'm like, listen, I don't know what transpired. I don't know how this happened, but you guys know me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a troublemaker.
Yeah.
I'm not a problem. I play by the rules unless it's incredible humidity. And they said, David Hill is Australian. I'm like, well, you're bad. I'll take care of it. So I get back in. They get me my credential back.
Oh.
But the rest of the Super Bowl, I couldn't enjoy it. You know, I'm sweating. I'm like sad. I missed most half the first half of the Super Bowl.
Yeah, you didn't miss
and
much.
And Terry's like, what's going on, little guy? What's happening over there? You got a problem? I got kicked out of the Super Bowl. Oh, my plan worked. We got ready, Italiano. Come on. Don't make fun of me. So it was, but it was one of those just surreal moments. And there was actually another comedian who's Craig Shoemaker, who had video of it. He was just videoing because he saw me being walked out.
And so does that still exist today?
I think Shoemaker probably has it. I didn't ever want to see it again.
What is your credential for Super Bowl 54 look like?
I'm going to be back home. My family's at
so
at
you're
home.
No longer allowed to be at the Super Bowl.
No,
on
I've
Super
been
Sunday
kicked out
now.
Of all Super Bowls.
It's amazing.
It's like one of those things.
To this day.
Yeah, I'm not allowed back in ever again. I'm allowed to come during the week and talk about the Super Bowl. but I'm never allowed to be near the Super Bowl.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.